Is it rolling?
It's on.
All right, awesome. All right. What are some common what are some common ground issues that both parties have to show people that kind of in an election where there's been a lot of aggression this year that we're really not all that far apart as a country?
Well, you know, I would hope that some of those common ground issues would be things, some of the things we mentioned in there. Certainly public safety is something that we should all agree on. Nobody should want to defund the police. Everybody should be on board with trying to end the fentanyl crisis. Everybody should be on board with trying to go after the bad actors and drug dealers who are dealing this poison in our communities. And everybody should be on board with supporting our police officers and giving them what they need to be proactive in fighting crime. Everybody should be on board when it comes to making sure that our children can read and write and do mathematics. That's the basis of a sound education. Everybody should be on board, both parties, when it comes to our great infrastructure system. And everybody should be on board when it comes to making sure we're delivering great health care. You know, a lot of what we're seeing in politics right now is, quite frankly, just out of sheer immaturity. People don't want some other party to get credit or some other person to get credit. What we need are real leaders who will push that aside and do what's necessary to work with both parties to end up with satisfaction. Solutions and great policies that work for us.
What do you think are important issues to young people and young voters?
Well, we're seeing a myriad of things important to young voters, but one of the things we're seeing more and more with young people have a very strong streak of entrepreneurial, a strong entrepreneurial spirit, and they want to have ways where they can segue their talents into be able to making great careers. I think that's one of the reasons why it's so important for elected officials to involve young people in the process. If you go back and you look through history, many of our greatest inventions came from young people. Young people have great expansive minds. They're open to anything. We need to harness that energy and make sure that these young people have the tools that they need to be successful.
Why is it important for young people and high schoolers to be up to date with political issues?
From the very earliest time after our children learn to read, I believe we need to teach them how their constitutional republic operates. They need to understand the government structure and they need to understand the political process because they are at the top of the order, not the bottom. Oftentimes in our society, we get it wrong. We think the congressman, the senator, the president, we think those are the people that are on top. We think they are, quote, the boss. They are not the boss. The bosses are the people who vote for them. They're the ones that should be driving this process. And the more literate our electorate becomes about the political process, I believe the better candidates and the better elected officials we'll see being in office.
What's one thing you would want people to know about you?
One thing that I want people to know about me is this. I am not running for office to have a political career. I don't think anyone should have, quote, a political career. You should have a career serving your community. As an elected official, not a politician, as an elected official, it's my duty to serve the people who of my state or my constituency in my area, if I'm a congressman or senator or a house member. It's my duty to represent those folks and allow them to have their voices heard to me so that I can represent them properly. So the one thing I want folks to know, I'm going to be a governor for everybody, not just those who voted for me, but everybody.
Alrighty, thank you. That's all I've got.